I'd advise against it, in your case, at least. No disrespect intended, but this is not your typical magic. It's been mostly drained, but even now contains a powerful dose of shadow weave. The discarded pixie corpses might still contain enough essence. With one of the broken lantern casements... Yes, I think I'll be able to craft one more lantern. And with a slight modification of the casting gesture, it might be able to wield the shadows instead of repelling them. Though, Mistress' eyes may be upon me. She'd forbid me dabbling with such magic. She'd want it destroyed. Wasted, arguably. Deal with it how? I hate to pull rank, but I was once Mistress Chosen. Destroying magic like this was my bread and butter. Oh, or did you wish to use it? I assure you, it's pointless. You'll have nothing more than a sore head and a very dissatisfied wizard to show for it. Oh, charming. I hope the Shadow Weave was to blame for that little outburst of unwarranted discourtesy. If you think you know best, go right ahead. God, you're obstinate. Go ahead, then. Do your worst. There's the makings of a fine follower of Mistra within you, give or take a few decades of studying the weave. Now, given my magical expertise is of limited use to you, was there something else you wanted to ask me about? There's nothing that would give me greater pleasure.
No, I won't kill them.
Well, maybe Gale.
Sulfur, decay, and a thin whiff of something unexpectedly fragrant. The mead tastes of rot and sour milk. Your stomach lurches, but your loins tingle. Was that arousal?
If what is happening is what I think is happening, and it's because you licked a dead spider, the time might just have come when you and I should split ways.
In amongst the rot is an unmistakable sweetness. Succubus spittle. The meat is charmed. The carcass continues to leak. Your guts cramp, your stomach churns, and your nerves burn with a pain that would almost be pleasurable were it not so savage.
Stop licking the damn thing!
Oh, was that Gale's granddad? Yeah, it doesn't ring a bell. But all right. Must have had something important to say to Gale if he came all this way. Good news, I hope. Whoa now, he's got a... Well, I guess that would explain a little, but... Mistra? I mean, this is a lot to take in. What's he going to do? There's devotion and then there's stupidity. If the god of magic can't handle this without sacrificing Gale, she's no god at all.
Poor Gale.
He must be in bits after hearing that. I'll distract him. Tell him I haven't read a book since secondary school. Watch his face melt off. I've got a long road ahead. No traps, please.
I gave my return to Baldur's Gate a lot of thought. I never pictured this, though.
Oh, what did you have in mind? A quiet party? Toasting a return with a few good friends?
Less quiet party with friends, more days of hedonistic debauchery. But otherwise, yes.
Sounds like a recipe for disaster. But you know what? I'm learning to enjoy the taste of chaos. Count me in. Well, generosity is always a noble virtue, whether it be in the streets, by the charity box, or betwixt the sheets. Besides, given my propensity towards verbosity, surely can't be a surprise that I have a practiced tongue. I hope that night meant as much to you as it did to me. And I hope we all have more time together. Together. Alone. I see. Well, fine is fine. Nobody weeps because the weather is fine. No monarchs were overthrown because their ruling was fine. No artworks were burned because they were not masterpieces, but merely fine. Oh. Well, I hope I didn't make too much of an ass of myself. Just now. I'll see that there is indeed more to come. Won't betide anyone who tries to stop me.
Not to my taste, but I'll take a clown over some hack magician pulling peonies from his breeches.
Truly. I might as well go mount the gallows.
Oh! My heart! The enthusiasm is too much! Now, up, up! Double sharp! Or poor Buddy will think you don't like him. Right there! Oh, perfect!
You truly are testing the patience of a man who could level a city if he wished, you know?
Think, if the wizard were given the choice, what food would he be?
You think so little of me? At least you didn't compare me to a spotted dick.